Wisconsin.
If you want to find out about wrestling, you go to the source, and here is the source, Mr. Wrestling, Fred Kohler.
Well, it's nice being here again. Well, Mel, last week we talked about this Henning, this Paul Henning, and we saw him again this week. He did a good job in beating his opponent this week, and you mark my word, that man will be in line for a title match very shortly.
I can understand how you feel about him, Fred, because not only is he seems to be outstanding in the ring, but appears to be a gentleman and is certainly well spoken out of the ring.
Yes, he's the one wrestler that I don't think any promoters will have any trouble with. He loves wrestling, and he's making a career of it, and he's very quiet. He's not obnoxious. He doesn't brag. And I think he's the kind of stock a real champion is made out of.
I was quite amazed myself, Fred, in watching him in action to note that for a man of his size, 6'3", 240 pounds, that he is as light on his feet and as quick and agile as he is.
Well, that's unusual in a heavy man. And incidentally, I'm introducing a lot of men. Right now I'm negotiating with a great wrestler in Germany and one in South America, and I expect to show him into Chicago pretty short, as soon as I can get him in this country.
Well, the man making the big noise up in the ring, if you don't recognize him, that's the Moose Kid himself. Big Moose Cholak. He's from Moosehead, Maine. And I think a lot of the ringsiders here wish he was right back there. They are not fond of him. His opponent, the Music Man, Daddy Siki. And Daddy is getting a sour note right now. The match is underway. From Kingston, Jamaica. Moosehead, Maine. Big Moose Cholak. And Moose is giving Daddy what for. Jamaica giving it all for purse and country. one didn't do Daddy a bit of good. And the Moose Man unloads his best block. On top of Sweet Daddy now, and those candied striped trunks. Sweet Daddy are doing the most good as he lays down 60 pounds of Moose Cholak. Say what you will about Moose, but don't ever sell him short. He is a rugged cookie in there. For the moment, there goes that head twist again. Good close-up study of the man from Kingston, Jamaica. Big Daddy Siki and Sweet Moose Cholak. No pun intended. Moose call and shakes the wall. Sweet Daddy apparently getting his second win. Coming on with just a head and body. Scissors now by Moose Cholak. Hey, It's been a grueling match. Top from the opening bell. A real rugged 10 or 12 minutes or so. But that's the kind of action you can expect to see here at the home of champions, wrestling champions, Marigold Arena in Chicago. It's world famous, and if you are thinking of visiting Chicago, well, by golly, consider this a standing invitation. Come on out and visit us at Marigold. Matt Alberts at ringside here, speaking for promoter Fred Kohler, telling you it's open house at Marigold Arena whenever you're in Chicago. So make your next visit complete with a visit to Marigold, and you'll have a ball looking at the best the world has to offer in wrestling. Sweet Daddy looks like he's being choked. Referee Fred Lederer wants to know. He asked Big Moose to show him a little space between arm and neck. Maybe that sleeper hold, and Sweet Daddy is in big trouble. Sweet Daddy is slowly lapsing into unconsciousness, I believe. Sweet Daddy having a terrible time summoning up any strength. Strength to break out of this mess he's in, and Moose Cholak just as determined not to let it happen. Daddy managed to get on the ropes, and because of that, Fred Lederer got a break, and Daddy is going to get a chance to draw some nice fresh air. But not for long. Here's the Moose back. Again, Daddy on the verge of unconsciousness, reaching down on that reserve somewhere for some extra strength. What makes a great athlete in any sport, being able to give all you got and then somewhere find a little bit more. And evidently Daddy has done just that. There's the Jamaica Buck, the Jamaica Blockbuster. Here's the whip. With Moose Cholak. He whips him into the turnbuckle again. I tell you, I'm half scared with this ring is just liable to completely dissolve when Moose runs into that corner. It just may explode into a thousand little pieces. And Sweet Daddy committed the cardinal sin. Sweet Daddy committed the cardinal sin. kicks in. He has laid hands on an official of the Illinois State Athletic Commission, and Sweet Daddy has done the unpardonable. That is all. He's not finished with Musso, but he is going to be disqualified in this one. The match is over, and so is Moose Cholak, but Sweet Daddy is not yet done. Referee Fred Lederberg is trying to get Danny out of there. He committed the unpardonable sin. He laid hands on the official. Tonight we talk to a gentleman from Mexico City, Mexico. I say a gentleman advisedly. His name, Ricky Cortez. And Ricky, you've seen the majority of the wrestlers in the land south of the border. Now you've had a good look at those north of the border. What would be your summation of the top wrestler in the game today?
Well, I think offhand, I could name quite a few who would be very near the top, but in all honesty, I can truthfully say that I think the best wrestler today is myself. As I've shown you people before that I can defeat any man, I proved it tonight, and I will prove it again. And as a matter of fact, any man who wants to wrestle me, I'll pay his plane fare anywhere, anytime, in any ring, just to prove that I'm the world's greatest wrestler.
Well, it's a very strong statement, Ricky. There are a lot of men that I'm sure would find that a very difficult statement to accept.
I have never been defeated in the ring, you understand. And I wrestled almost all over the world, and I've yet to meet a man who could defeat me.
Well, of course, there are a lot of men you have not yet met.
That's strictly because they stay away from me. When I go to some place to wrestle, they take off. That would include everybody from the world champion right on down.
Do you feel it is necessary in a wrestler, to be a successful wrestler, to have this great confidence in your own ability that is almost on the braggadocious side?
Well, speaking from the record, I'm not trying to say that I'm great or that I'm a terrific wrestler, because these things I have to prove to people, which I've done continually. As a matter of fact, like tonight, you'll see what I mean. There isn't possibly one man standing or living that can possibly beat me in a ring. I'm what you call a human tornado. Look at these muscles. Sure see a man like that before. And I use that to beat every man I ever wrestled. And any man that you can bring into this ring, I'll be more than glad to wrestle him, and I'm sure that I can defeat him. Fair and square.
Well, Ricky, it takes more often than not a little bit more than something here or or something here. I think a lot of times you got to have something up there. Now, I'm not questioning whether you do or don't, but I have often seen a good little man beat a not-so-good big man.
Well, now, you see, when you make a reference to my intelligence, you've got to remember that I am a college man, and I was a champion in Mexico, and I have traveled all over the world, and I have beaten every man I have ever wrestled. Now, about a big man beating, or a little man beating a big man, because the big man doesn't know how to wrestle. And you can be sure there is no little man or no big man is ever going to defeat me in any ring at any time. This you can rest assured of.
Well, that's my point, Ricky Cortez. What I mean is that it takes more than a great body and great muscular control to be a champion.
I've got a great mind, too, you see.
Well, that's what I was trying to
find. I have a great mind, I have a great body, I have a great wrestling technique, and therefore I should be the world's greatest wrestler, which I am proving to everybody, and I'm sure that these people will agree with me.
Well, whether they agree with you or not, I think is unimportant at this time, because everybody is entitled to their own opinion. The fact of the matter remains that you agree with yourself.
Yes, and before this is over, you'll see.
I'm sorry, we're about to run out of time. I just want to tell you it's been interesting and good luck.
But I'll be back, and I want to tell you people some more later.
Ricky Cortez, Mexico City.